Ken the Worshipper! Where's all of my praises? I want everybody around the world to put your hands together because all the praise belongs to God. Here we go.
I would have lost it all. But now I see you was there for me. I never would have made it. I never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see you was there for me. I can see I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, so much better. When I look back over my life, I see where you brought me through. I realize it was you that I held on to. Never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
I would have lost my mind long time ago. You was there to see me through. Never would have made it. I never could have made it without you, God.
Never could have made it without you.
I should have lost my mind a long time ago. You was there to see me through. Now I'm stronger.
I'm stronger.
I'm wiser. And I'm wiser. I'm better. So much better. When I look back over my life, I see you was there to see me through. It was you that I held on to. I never could have made it. I never would have made it without you. Without you.
Here we are again preparing for our tithes and our offering. And I need to say to you from the bottom of my heart that I certainly appreciate your generosity to the Shiloh Church, for indeed you have been extremely faithful in supporting our church, supporting our tithes with tithes and supporting our offering with generous offerings. And I say to you that we would not be able to do the things that we're able to do to help those within the community, to help those who are in need, to help children get back to school the way they should get back to school if it were not for you. And for those tithes and offering, I say to you that we're extremely grateful. You will find that there are multiple ways in which to give your tithes as well as your offerings. They're on the screen for you. And from the bottom of my heart, I say thank you for all that you have done and shall continue to do for the Shiloh Church. Our Father and our God, we ask now as we come to give our tithes and give our offerings, we ask that you will bless them in a very special way. And it is our prayer, O God, that this tithe as well as this offering will be used for the building of your kingdom. It's in your Son's name that we pray. Amen, amen. And again, thank you for your tithes as well as your offerings.
Somebody is going through something right now. Sickness in your body. You've lost your job. You've lost your home. You've lost your car. You've lost your marriage. You've lost your kids. The economy has affected you and your family. My friend, you need a breakthrough.
I'm going through some things.
Nothing.
But nothing can turn me around.
Listen.
A little wind and some rain, but it can't touch the joy I found.
Gonna
put my trust in you.
Only in you, God.
Whatever problem
no
I'm in, I know.
In the Gospel of Luke, the 19th chapter and the 40th verse, we find these words, "And he answered and said unto them, I tell you that if these should hold their peace," if you hold your peace, "the stones would immediately cry out." On this second Sunday in November, in the year of our Lord 2020, we stand here on such a blessed occasion. It is our 136th church anniversary. And not a lot of places can say that they've lasted for 136 years. And of those 136 years, I stand here today as pastor of the Shiloh Church of Plano, saying that as of now, I'm the third pastor in the last 98 years in the history of this church. And that is in itself is a blessing. And I thank God for that opportunity. And so I just want to talk this morning to you for just a little while. And I want to talk about 136 years and we're still shouting. 136 years and we're still shouting. We, the members of the Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church of Plano, Texas, are shouting praises to God this morning for 136 years of just being able to tell God thank you. And on this 136th year of dedicated praise and worship, we cannot hold our peace. Listen, if for no other reason than the fact that God has kept us through the storm as well as through the rain, and yet we vow to keep shouting. If there was ever a time when the church needed to shout loudly and clearly, can I tell you that now is the time? We're living in a time where the enemy is going to and fro, seeking whom he may devour. And the weaknesses that are the weakness that we find in the local church is that the local church seems to do well on the inside of the four walls. But when we get on the outside of the four walls, that's where we become silent. But I have watched God work, because never would I have thought this time last year that on our 136th anniversary that I would be standing preaching to an empty building. The building is empty, but the church marches on, and the church is yet shouting. So we have to make some noise outside of the four walls. We have gotten to the point, and we had gotten to the point where we came on Sunday and did our 2 hours. And once we put in our 2 hours, we felt as though we had fulfilled our responsibility for the week. But God decided that he would do something different. You see, Satan plays a part in this too, because he recognizes that if he's going to bring us down and bring down as many Christians as he can possibly bring down, then he has to work 24/7, 365 days per year. And you need to know that while you are on your job, while you're in church, you need to know while you're even sleeping at night, that the devil is always trying to plot something to make you stop worshiping and praising God. But the Shiloh church is proud to say that 136 years, and we're still shouting, we're still praising God. And that's why we need to pray every day, and pray before we go to work, and pray before we go to church, and pray before we go to bed. And if you're not careful, you will have some unnecessarily bad days if you fail to pray. You see, Satan is trying to corrupt us and corrupt our world, and he does not want us and does not want you to know the truth. In fact, if you really want to know the truth, Satan is not even caring about you. But SMBC, we are 136 years strong and still holding on to God's unchanging hand. And somebody out there ought to say amen. You see, when we made up our minds that we were going to serve God, the devil became permanently upset with us. Now, do me a favor, and I need you to do some self-talk this morning, and I need you to tell yourself, say, self, listen, he can stay mad at this church. He can stay mad at Shiloh, but he will never have us. And tell yourself it's too late now. And tell Satan it's too late. And in fact, tell Satan this. Say, Satan, if you were going to destroy us, then you should have done it before this pandemic. You should have gotten us before the pandemic, because this pandemic has taught us that there's nothing that God cannot bring us through. We have been locked up. We have been given orders to stay home. Some of us have lost our jobs. We've been furloughed. We've had to draw unemployment. And yet we're still holding and praising God, because he has shown himself to be our keeper. So why are you able to still praise God? I know the times when you would have fallen apart. I know a time when you would have broken down. But why are you able to still praise God? Look at yourself and say, self, I'm just not what I used to be. And then be honest with yourself and say, now I admit to yourself that I gave the devil his time, but now that I'm on the Lord's side, I'm not going back. And that was quite a statement to make when you say that you're not going back. Don't just say it, but mean what you say. You see, a lot of Christians just let the devil basically walk all over them. And these days, we're not speaking out enough, and we're not shouting enough, and we're not praising God enough. But you see, when you have gone through hell and you've gone through high water, and you know that God is the one that brought you out, when you know that God has been your keeper for 136 years, like he's kept the Shiloh church, you don't mind opening your mouth, you don't mind telling somebody how good God has been, and you don't mind telling somebody that had it not been for the Lord on our side, we never would have made it. But before you say anything, we must learn to do this. We've got to learn to do what the Bible tells us to do, because the Bible says, it really says that a fool's lips bring him strife and his mouth invites a beating. A fool's mouth is his undoing and his lips are the snare of his soul. The tongue has the power of life and death, and those who love it will eat its fruit. These verses almost sound like we don't have the right to remain silent, but the truth of the matter is that we cannot be quiet. We cannot hold our peace. How can a church that God has kept together for 136 years, how can a church that God has kept going steady and going straight for 136 years not come together and give God some kind of praise? I know so many good church folks who are afraid to declare with their mouths what the Word of God says about them. And if you don't hear anything else that I say today, I want you to hear this, that after 136 years, Shiloh, there is some power in you, and your power is in your mouth. Let's see what God's word says about this. I just have 3 points that I want to give you, and after I give them to you, I'm getting out of here. The first thing you got to learn how to do is you got to learn how to speak life into your own life. Watch what you say. Watch what you say. If you're going to tell somebody something, you got to watch what you say. You can't just say any old thing. Too many of us are speaking defeat in our lives when God said that death and life are in the power of the tongue. What are you saying, preacher? Well, here's what the Bible says. God's word, the Bible says, is a conquering name. Philippians 2, 10 and 11 says that every knee shall bow and every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So when the devil comes your way and starts messing with you, just put the word of God on him. Just start speaking the word of God to him. And when you speak the word of God, you actually begin to put God in the middle of the fight. You got to learn how to put God in the middle of the battle. Remember, this battle is not yours. This battle is not mine. This battle is the Lord. And God told us to defeat the devil by rebuking him. And in order to rebuke him, you have got to learn how to continue to praise him no matter what you're going through. John 1:1 says that in the beginning was the Word, and it says the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the same it was in the beginning with God. Genesis 1:1 says, in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. And in chapter 1 alone, you will find these words, these 3 words, and God said, and you're going to find it time after time after time after time again. And in John 1:14, and the Word became flesh, is what it says. And David says in Psalms 119:11, he said, thy word have I hidden in my heart that I may not sinned against God. And the word hidden means that these are the words that I have memorized. These are the words that I've embedded in my mind. These are the words that I have planted in my heart. You see, when Satan attempted to tempt Jesus in the wilderness, he was actually trying to subdue Jesus's mission to the cross. For 136 years, Satan has been trying to throw roadblocks in Shiloh's way. But every roadblock that's been thrown in our way, God has caused us to make a detour and go around it. And that's why we're still shouting after 136 years. When Satan came up against Jesus in the wilderness, Jesus didn't say, I don't know what I'm going to do. He just opened his mouth, and this is what he did. The Bible says that he quoted the words of God, and he said, it is, somebody help me out, it is written. So if Jesus can speak the word of God, if Jesus can say what the word says, then we ought to be able to open our mouths and say what the word says. And that's why we ought to still be shouting, and we ought to still be praising after 136 years. See, you got to understand this. You got to understand that Satan does not fear you. Satan is not bothered by you. Satan does not care how smart you are. Satan doesn't care how many degrees you have. Satan does not care about your enunciation of words. Satan is only afraid of the fact that you know the word of God. Somebody help me out this morning. You see, church, we need to speak the word of God. We need to act upon the word of God. And most of all, we need to attack the devil with the word of God. When the devil comes roaring like a lion, we need to speak back and start talking back to him. And you need to tell him, I am what this book says I am. I was 136 years ago when Shiloh got its beginning. It said, I'm more than a conqueror. And the conqueror that I was 136 years ago, I'm still that conqueror. When defeat tries to take you out, you need to speak back and say, I can do what the book says I can do. The word 136 years ago said, SMBC said, listen, you can do all things through Christ which strengthens you. And the same word that was good 136 years ago is good today. When the enemy tries to attack your body, tries to attack your mind, and tries to attack your soul, you need to talk back to the enemy. I have what this book says I have. Listen, you got to understand that the word said to SMBC 136 years ago that I have been given authority to trample on snakes and scorpions and to overcome the power of the enemy, and nothing can harm me. And when what seems like impossibilities come upon you, you need to speak back, and you need to talk, and you need to say that 136 years ago, we learned that nothing is impossible to them that believe and are called according to his purpose. The word says that 136 years, we've been believing in it, that is sharper than a two-edged sword. Listen, it's been milk for infants for 136 years. It's been meat for mankind for 136 years. This word has been hope at the Shiloh Church for 136 years to the hopeless. It's been a friend to the friendless for 136 years. This word for 136 years at the Shiloh Church has conquered death, hell, and the grave. And the word for 136 years conquered depression. This word conquered demon powers. And most of all, this word can transform any negative situation into a positive one. I'm feeling like preaching this morning. So you got to learn to speak life over yourself. You got to learn to change negative situations into positive situation by speaking the word of God. If it's sickness in your life, then put some praise on it. If you need healing, then put some praise on it. If you need deliverance, I tell you, put some praise on it. If you need your finances fixed, put some praise on it. What do you mean by put some praise on it? Before it ever happens, you need to put some praise on it. We are a great example of what to look back upon and see where God has brought us from. And if he brought us from there, he can certainly keep us. Listen, this church started with nothing. Six little people that decided that they were going to build a church and they were going to have a place to worship. And somebody came by and gave them some land in which to worship in. And after six people started 136 years, we're still holding fast to God's unchanging hand. And we can testify that the Lord has brought us a mighty long way. It's the word that conquers the prince of darkness. It's the word that puts him in his place. When Satan says you're defeated, don't buy what Satan says. Don't believe what Satan says. That's when you got to start shouting. What do I shout, preacher? I don't know what to shout. Let me tell you what to shout when you are trying to be defeated by Satan. You just stand boldly and just shout that the Lord is my light and my salvation, and whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life, and of whom shall I be afraid? And when Satan whispers that you're no good, you just tell him, listen, for 136 years we've been holding on to God's unchanging hand, and that's why we can testify, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners. The counsel of the ungodly is those who stand against Christ. And you should be like a tree planted by the rivers of water. Your leaf shall not wither, and wherefore whatsoever you do it shall prosper. When Satan tells the doctor to tell you you're sick and you're never going to get well, you got to start putting some praise on something. You got to say, I am the Lord your God that heals all of your diseases. Say to yourself, by his stripes I am healed. Say to yourself that the Lord sent his word and his word healed me. Say to yourself, I feel like preaching this morning, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that was in me, and forget not all of his benefits, and who forgives us from all of our sins and heals us from all of our diseases. Say, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. You got to learn to speak the word of God and watch the prince of darkness run for his life and watch him run in terror. And most of all, watch him bow at your feet. You see, God is an awesome God, and you need to start acting like God is an awesome God, and you need to start putting some praise on whatever you do. You got to learn how to stop speaking defeat and speak life into yourself, and you got to learn how to change negative situations into positive situations, and you have to learn how to do what it takes to make it until God comes back. Sometimes we just have to make it on our praise. For 136 years, there were some times when we didn't know how as a church we were going to make it. But what we learned how to do is just come together and just praise the Lord. There were times back in the day when we didn't have a musician. We didn't have a drummer. We didn't have a bass player. We didn't have a lead guitarist. But we had old church souls that knew how to come together. And before you could get to the church house, you could hear the souls, like the heels of the women, just rocking their feet on the floor and tapping their heels on the floor. And you could hear them break out in old songs that, "Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, oh, whither shall I go?" We knew how to praise God, and we got to keep shouting, and we got to keep praising God. All you got to do is give God some praise. Give yourself a pat on the shoulder and just say, "Self, I'm getting ready to praise God like I've lost my mind. I know you're going through. I know the devil is trying to tell you that you're the only one going through, but you're not the only one going through. There are people in here, people at home, who are going through something worse than you've ever gone through, but they still making it. And I found out that the only way that you're going to make it is you got to make it on praise." Let me say that again. You got to make it on praise. You got to make it on praise. You got to make it on praise. You see, you can make it with Jesus. You got to make up in your mind that you don't care who don't like you. You don't care who don't speak to you. You're going to seek the face of God. I found out that sometimes you're going to be all by yourself. I found out that sometimes you have to walk this lonely road by yourself. And I found out that sometimes nobody else is walking with you. You don't have a buddy system, but you got to learn how to walk this journey by yourself. And while you're on the road, you got to learn how to open your mouth and just give God some praise. I'm getting ready to bring this thing to a close, but let me tell you that your words will either confirm your faith or it will deny your faith. And your words should agree with what God has already spoken in the word. And then you should refuse to be moved by the circumstances that come up in your life. Someone said, "I am not moved by what I see and what I feel and what I hear, but I'm moved only by God's word." And you cannot believe in your own heart and deny with your mouth, because what you say with your mouth is exactly what rules you. Do you understand that we have that same power that Jesus exercised when he ascended? This is the same power that you and I have today. It's the same power that gave the lame man at the gate called Beautiful a healing blessing. It's the same power when Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." It's the same power that raised the widow's son. It's the same power that turned water into wine. And it's the same power that caused the blind to see. And it's the same power that set the captives free. And that means that if that you're free and whom the Son sets free, and free indeed. I know I got to get out of here, but it's the power that when David said, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want, joy, and for in his presence is the fullness of joy. I shall not want peace, for he is the Prince of Peace. I shall not want love, for God is love. I know I got to go, but I shall not want friendship, because he's a friend that's sticking closer than a brother. I got to go, but I'm feeling this thing, and I shall not want leadership, but he is my shepherd, and he guides me, and he provides for me. I shall not want anointing, for he anoints my head with oil, and surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. I shall not want for prosperity, because he prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies. I shall not want for eternal life, for I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever, and his kingdom there shall be no end. Hallelujah. Can I get you to say hallelujah? Is there anybody here this morning that can give God some praise? I'm talking about, is there anybody in your home that can come to your feet and just give God some praise for being our keeper for 136 years? Listen, is there anybody that know God's been good to you? If you know God's been good, then you ought to come to your feet and just give God an undignified praise. Listen, Paul said to the church, he said, fight on the good fight of faith. He said, endure the goodness, soldiers of Jesus Christ. Endure. He said, engage the enemy with the weapons of the warfare in the power of his name, in the power of his blood, and in the authority of his words. Let God arise. Let his enemies be scattered. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody ought to be praising God. Somebody ought to tell God, thank you. Somebody ought to tell Jesus, I thank you, because you went to Calvary. You gave your only son, and you went to Calvary, and he died there on the cross on our behalf. And somebody ought to tell God that we sure do thank you this morning. Well, I got to get out of here. I know I've said it 4 or 5 times. But I'm getting ready to get out of here this time. But before I get out of here, I've just been thinking today about how good God has been to us over this 136 years. And I got to give a report of the goodness of God. And he's been food on our table for 136 years. He's been a way out of no way for 136 years. He's been waking us up for 136 years. He started us on our way for 136 years. He's been water on our table for 136 years. He's a very present help in the time of trouble. He's been the air that we breathe for 136 years. He's continued to blow breath into the life of the Shiloh church. And David said, let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Shiloh, you ought to be giving God some praise for how good God has been to us for 136 years. He's been a shelter in the time of storm. And I got to ask you this morning, is he all right? Is he all right? Yes, he is. He's my all and all. He is my shepherd, and I shall not want it. And I ain't ashamed of the fact that I love the Lord. He heard my cry. I ain't ashamed of the fact that he's been my keeper for 136 years here at the Shiloh Church. I know I ain't been here all of them, but I'm a part of the family. And because you're a part of the family, you got to admit that we've had some ups and we've had some downs. But through it all, you got to admit that God has been good to us, and you ought to give him praise this morning. You ought to be able to say, I just can't help myself.
And you ought to have it. I can't help myself shout for 136 years. Let me leave you with this. You remember this. If you won't cry out, he'll have the rocks do it, and he'll do it immediately. At every church on Sunday morning, when you walk in, there's some rocks somewhere near the church, and they're lined up, and they have resumes in their hands. And the resume says that if they won't cry out, we'll go in and do it for him. Well, we're not in here this morning, but somebody ought to be crying out in their homes this morning about the goodness of God. 136 years. 136 years. And still shouting. Still praising. How can you do it? How can you do anything for 136 years? Well, how can he have kept us 136 years? It was but by his son, Jesus Christ, that we've been able to call upon, lean on, and depend on. And this morning I stand to open the doors of the church and tell you that if you don't know his son Jesus, I want to invite you to get to know him. The doors of the church stand to open. You'll find that there will be a number on our screen this morning, and when that number's on our screen, I invite you to take it down. I invite you to call it and ask you to ask them to connect you with Pastor Joshua, one of the other ministers here, and I guarantee you we'll reach out to you and we'll convince you that Jesus is the best thing that ever happened to us. 136 years, we've been putting it in his hands. This and that, we put it all in his hands. That's how good God has been to us. He's been a keeper. He's just been a keeper, Shiloh. And if you're part of this family, even if you have joined this church, you just ought to be praising God for keeping anybody 136 years. Nothing hardly lasts 136 years, but just look at God and what God is able to do. Our Father and our God, we come before you in the most humble way that we know how, bringing these your people. And as we bring them, there's somebody this morning that's heard how good you've been to us, and they want to sign up for the Christian Jubilee. They want their name written above. We want to introduce you to them this morning, King Jesus. And we ask you to ride this week in their lives. We ask you, oh God, to stir them up this week and allow them to call the church and become a part of the church family. It doesn't matter if it's at the Shiloh Church, but whatever church, we just need them to get their name on the roll above. We thank you for being our God and our Savior now. In your Son's precious name, we pray. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The doors of the church stand open. Take a moment, take a moment, take a moment, and just ask God to just pour down his blessings upon you. Ask God to speak to your heart right now. And then once you've done that, we ask you to do the rest, and that's to make the call. Make the move. God bless you, and God keep you. That's our prayer for you this morning here at the Shiloh Church. Allow me to pray for you for the week. Listen, 136 years, we ought to all leave here shouting today. We ought to be shouting in our homes. We ought to just be as happy as we can be for 136 years of blessings. Our Father and our God, we thank you now for the opportunity of worshiping you on this day, 136 years of existence. We glorify, edify, magnify your precious and awesome name. We bring your people to you now, and we ask God that you would be so kind as to order their steps this week and to keep them, oh God, within your care. We ask you to wrap your loving arms of protection around them. Keep us, oh God, from hurt, harm, and danger. God bless America. That's my request this week, is that you just bless America and that you do a turnaround in our situation. Bless this country. Bless each and every citizen thereof. Keep us, oh God, in your care. In Jesus' precious name I pray. Amen and amen. For our benediction, now unto our God and our Father, we say we thank you for the opportunity of being able to worship you on this very special Sunday in the life of the Shiloh Church. And we ask God that you would forever keep us in your care, that you would order our steps. Now unto our God and our Savior be power for now and forevermore. Amen, amen, and amen. This morning, our hug
comes from Audrey Newsome, a member of the Shiloh Church. The acronym is Holy Under God. Holy Under God. And Audrey, we say thank you for this. Your husband got his in, and I see you had to get yours in. So we thank you. We also solicit anyone else that wants to send in an acronym for HUG. We'll be more than honored to accept it. Thank you so very much again, Audrey. It's my time to give you that hug, and it's an honor and a privilege on this special Sunday to do so. So I'm going to ask you to just lean in for Pastor. Just lean in a little bit. You can do better. Come in closer. Come in closer. And I'm getting ready to give you a hug for 136 years, as big as I possibly can. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Let's go. God bless you. God keep you. I'm Pastor Isaiah Joshua, Senior Pastor here at the Shiloh Missionary Baptist Church of Plano, Texas. And again, I say thank you for worshiping with us, and I look forward to worshiping with you again on next Sunday. Blessings upon you this week.
So we lift our hands in the sanctuary, and we give you glory.